Mr. Conway's microphone and Ben's. So we're back up here in the booth as they start to get the double file. The 14 looking to the inside this time as they get ready to go green.
Yeah, I think Ross realized that after that last restart, doesn't matter where he starts, as long as he can get on the gas quick, he'll be out there in front. And I believe with Brockwell to his outside, he wants to keep him up there. I think Brockwell down to the or he'll try to keep Brockwell down there or up there, as Brockwell wants to get to the bottom line. Seems like he is just about as fast as one of the fastest cars out there. As we're going to go down real quick to Ben and get a quick update before we go green.
Yeah, quick before we go green here. I did talk to Steven. My microphone cut out too far out of range. He not very happy after tonight. He said he's hoping to turn his season around here in the PowerTek Power Solution Nationwide Series, and he's looking to come out strong next week.
Thank you, Ben, as we go back to the racing action here. James Ross leads him down. Pace car is in. It's all him. When's he going to take it? We wait. Green flag out. We're racing again. James Ross on it hard. He flies off that from the restart box into turns 1 and 2. Side by side for second position. They come up the corner. McEwen, he's going to clear Brockwell by a car and a half. He's going to get after James Ross now. McEwen not waiting around this time as he sees the opportunity. He's going to try to get to it. He gets to the inside of the 14. Side by side for the lead off of 4. At the third finish line, it looked like it was Ross. McEwen drives it down to the inside now. He's going to get there. And we're getting word there was... Oh, car loose in the middle of the pack. It was Rick Donovan. He saves it, though. Back to the front. Action still hot there as they go side by side for a second. Now James Ross, Dylan Brockwell. Brockwell able to slip by. He's going to get him to Tyler McEwen, and it's the race from Charlotte all over again. Take the fuel mileage out of it. And here were the two cars that were at the front almost all night long. On the other... We come down the back straightaway. McEwen and Brockwell. Still nose to tail here. McEwen able to open up a little lead, but I think Brockwell's going to be able to drive back to him here. Ross still able to hold on to third, but here comes Sturgeon to his bumper. He's looking to the inside now. And caution is out again. Whoa! Another car in the wall down there. TJ Woodward was around. Camaro wrecked down the front straightaway. Whitehead involved as well. And that is going to make things real interesting here. With 105 of 120 laps completed. And we will have to see how this one comes to a conclusion as we look back here. The 13 was involved as well as Mike Whitehead. Looks like the 13 just drove up the track and came back down. Whitehead was there. They touched. Around they go. Arm got into the wall, but nothing major. And then not quite sure what happened to Camara there. Looks like he just got on the brakes and tried to kick the car around on him.
From my viewpoint here, it looked like David Camara could possibly try to avoid the 99 of Mike Whitehead there and just tried swerving out of the way and got loose and spun it around.
And just a quick update there, as they were checking up under caution, Ben Nile looped it on the back straightaway. Not sure what happened there, as our points leader brings the car around. Looks like he'll be able to regain his position in line. But we look back to the front as our leader, Tyler McEwen. He is second in line at the moment. That's Mike Whitehead out front involved in that last accident. He is on the verge of going a lap down. Matt, closing in on about 10 laps to go here when we get the restart. Brockwell, McEwen, those two seem to be the strong cars. James Ross is still there, but I think with the two tires, he's not going to be a factor.
You're exactly right, Ian. I like to see the 14 obviously win this thing. He's a good guy. But I think the 20 car and the 1 car are exceptional tonight. I think it's going to come down to those two guys. I think if the 14 would have grabbed two more tires, 4 tires total, it would have been much more interesting here. But it's going to come down to Tyler McEwen and the 20 car of Dylan Brockwell.
We should see the 99 of Mike Whitehead waved around when we get the one to go, or one to green, I should say. He should get waved around the pace car, and you'll see McEwen form up behind it. Brian Terry is your wave around for this restart. Terry was waved around on the caution this time. And as we look at it here, there goes Terry past the leaders now. As we look, Tyler McEwen, the number one car, he sits first. Dylan Brockwell second. James Ross third. Brent Sturgeon in fourth, and Ben Nile, even after the spin under yellow, will sit fifth. That'll round out the Sam Bass Gallery's top five. I'd like to take a real quick moment to thank all of our sponsors for these series tonight. The PowerTek Power Solutions Nationwide Series, Noble Motorsports, Wiley X, all these guys that come out every week, and NASCAR Hall of Fame, Sam Bass Gallery's, all these guys that are supporting the three series that we run here, and the guys supporting everybody out here on the track. As we look here, waiting, we are going to send it down real quick to pit road with Ben Kilcrease. He has tuned in our in-race reporter, Brian Terry.
Kind of caught me by surprise. We're coming to one to go right now. I'll ask Terry real quick. Terry, not been the race that you've been looking for so far tonight. Are we just going to try and salvage it up and finish on the lead lap here?
Well, unfortunately, I'm not going to have any chance of getting back on the lead lap. Just going to try to pick up any spots in case there's one more wreck in these 11 laps. But just got to ride around here in the back, just try to salvage what I can.
Brian Terry, he will definitely be going for the W tomorrow night in the trucks when they head to Daytona. I mean, excuse me, Atlanta. Thank you, Brian, and we'll let you get the race.
Thank you, Ben. As we come back up here into the booth, Tyler McEwen and Dylan Brockwell sitting on that front row. James Ross, Brent Sturgeon right behind them. Ben Nile, William Roberts, your front three rows as the lights are out on that iRacing first Ford Mustang pace car. It paces the field through three and four. It'll turn down. Apologize for that. I'm a little behind there as they go green. Off into turn one. Tyler McEwen takes the lead. Dylan Brockwell able to clear James Ross. He's going to set his sights on the leader. As we come by this time, it'll be 10 laps to go. See if they can't settle this thing. Under green as we look back here. Ross still sitting third. Sturgeon closing again. Nile behind Sturgeon. And those three, actually the four, third through six, sit right on top of each other here as they come through one and two. Nose to tail there for fourth position. Brent Sturgeon, Ben Nile in the 29 there in fifth position. And now here comes William Roberts to the inside of Nile, seeing if he can't rob a top five finish away. Can't quite get it as Nile's able to slam the door. Nile, one of the few drivers done who's been able to make that outside line work. Sturgeon, Ross, they sit third and fourth. Right now it's Tyler McEwen and Dylan Brockwell out front. McEwen, he's going to come across the line now. Seven to go. Now Tyler McEwen up off the corner. Slow car down to the bottom. This Dave Camara. He'll pass him with ease as well as Brockwell. Now Brockwell, this is his race at the moment. He needs to get back to McEwen, but I'm not sure if he can. These guys have been evenly matched all night, and with the restart McEwen got, it's going to be a task. About half a second between the two of them out front right now. Caution on the track. Hill 5. Hill 10. Ortiz, he got around, looks like off into the corner there. Oh, just got touched by Rick Donovan and backed it into the wall. Did get run into there by the 13, TJ Woodward, nowhere to go. And definitely not the way you want to see it. Coming down to the end of these things.
Yeah, and that 13-05 for that maintenance for another night. It's unfortunate to see Milton Tease getting caught up in these accidents, because he was doing really well, sitting, I believe, in the top five at one time.
Yes, but Matt, with that caution, it may set up a very good situation here. We may have a green-white checkered here to run it down. We'll have to see. They come. They look here. McEwen still leads Brockwell. At this point, that caution was probably Dylan Brockwell's best friend and worst nightmare at the same time. He's going to have an excellent restart, but I don't think he had the car to catch the number one of Tyler McEwen. As Ben, we're getting a report there was an incident down there on pit road with the 05.
Yeah, I didn't quite catch it, but I did hear some crashing in the back. See if I can't get a replay up and verify exactly what happened.
10-4, thank you, Ben. Don't want that. Let me come. As we look now, as they just still on that pace car. We'll have to see here as one of those incidents near the end of the race where it looked like they were just racing hard, got together, and around they went. Unfortunate for a couple guys involved there, but McEwen's still out front. Matt, we're coming to the end of this thing. Who's going to win it? Here we got Brockwell and McEwen out front. They seem to have the cars to beat, but is it going to be the 1 or the 20 at this point?
Well, if the 20 car can get a good start here on the 1, it's going to be neck and neck. But if the 14 can stay on that 1 car's bumper, it could be any of those top three guys right now.
And as we look here, we're going to run you through with Sam Bass Gallery's top five. The number one car, Tyler McEwen, he leads. Dylan Brockwell, he sits second. James Ross, third. Brent Sturgeon sits fourth. And Ben Nile has moved his way up to fifth. As they sit, we look a little bit further back now. William Roberts in the 51 sits sixth. Sean Methling, seventh. Only able to fight back up to eighth tonight. William Long in ninth, and Ronald Henry just inside that top 10. If he can't get a good finish for himself tonight, up in the points. We come back to the front now. We'll have to look to see. Lights are out on the pace car. We are going to get a green-white checkered. Into turn number one, they'll start to double up. It'll be your front row will be McEwen and Brockwell. Ross and Sturgeon right behind them, and Nile and William Roberts will round out the front three rows. See what these guys can get as they get ready to drive the final three laps of this race. Hopefully we'll get them all in under green. Hopefully we'll see some good battling throughout the field to get back to the line. And here they come. Side. They look down the back straightaway. We'll have two laps to go when we take the green here at the Monster Mile. Got a quick update for you real quick. Any of you watching the 05 car, Milton Tease, he has pulled behind the wall. Now we look back to the front. The pace car is in. McEwen has control of the field. It's all on him. Can Brockwell get the start to match him? Waiting. Ross right on his bumper. McEwen goes.
Right.
Rockwell didn't quite get a start, but he's still there. Green in the air, two laps to go. They are still side by side for second position, or for third position. Back there is Ross able to clear Sturgeon again. They're going to get dicey behind them. It's all about the battle up front. They'll come off of four this time to get the white flag. Rockwell's driving hard. Can he get back to the one? Tyler McEwen takes the white flag. He's one lap away from a victory. Off into turn number one. It's Tyler McEwen's race to lose at this point. Dylan Brockwell far enough back. He should be able to catch him without any mistake. McEwen up off the corner. Keeps it off of that wall. Down through three and four. Two more corners to go. Off the final corner. Tyler McEwen will see the checkered flag. He'll win it here at Dover. He'll win the RD Design 120. Rockwell able to come across second and then just scattering behind him. James Ross third. Sturgeon in the 77 will bring it across fourth. Then William Roberts fifth. Ben Nile sixth. Dylan Lee seventh. Sean Medling eighth. Ronald Henry will bring him home ninth. And Scott Wallace will round out your top 10.
Well, like I said, Ian, if Tyler McEwen was able to get a good lead, get a good restart here, he would come home the victor. And that's exactly what he did tonight.
And Tyler McEwen burns the rear tires off the car, celebrates the victory here at Dover. We're going to send you to a quick commercial break, come back, get our interviews with our top three, and see if we can't get our we'll get our final thoughts on the night and give you an update on the final finishing position of everybody in the field.
I felt it all at the hall, where it's a cool 33 degrees.
We experienced it all at the hall, where my son became the fastest man ever.
I relived it all at the hall, where my grandson asked me, "Did you really do all that?"
Experience high-octane fun during NASCAR Hall of Fame's Cure for the Common Summer, presented by Coca-Cola.
Did your little storm knock out the power? Well, excuse me for not noticing. Hate to disappoint you, old man Winter. Better luck next time.
If the power goes out, your Generac standby generator goes on automatically.
Down trees, flash floods, is that all you've got?
Stand up to the threat of outages with Generac and never feel powerless.
Hey race fans, it's Carl Edwards, driver of the number 99 Aflac Ford Fusion with your eye safety tip of the week. Did you know that 90% of eye injuries can be avoided simply by wearing the proper ANSI-approved eyewear? More than 1 million Americans have lost some degree of sight due to eye injury. That's a risk that I'm just not willing to take. Go to WileyX.com to find a dealer near you and to learn more about the first premium performance sunglass company whose entire product line meets occupational safety standards. That's WileyX.com. Wiley X. Safety never looks so cool.
Welcome back here.
I felt it all at the hall.
Welcome back.
We're
to
a cool 33 degrees.
Right here, as we have completed the RD Designs 120 in the PowerTek Power Solutions Nationwide Series, brought to you by NobleMotorsports.com. Down on pit road, I believe. Our lovely pit road reporter, Ben Kilcrease, has caught up with the third place finisher, the driver of the number 14 PowerTek Power Solutions car, James Ross. Ben, have you caught up with James?
Yeah, I've caught up with the lovely James Ross here tonight at Dover International Speedway season sponsor. Yeah, I guess you could say that. Season and series sponsor here at the PowerTek Power Solutions. James, you come out third tonight. Your car was digging.
Yeah, I didn't have quite the speed these guys did, so pulled a little strategy move there towards the end, and, would have liked to know what would have happened if I didn't take two on that last stop. I took four. Maybe I might have had something for these guys, but probably was the right move for me. Gave us a decent finish. Nearly done. Darn near came away from the win if I'd stopped looking in the mirror.
Yeah, I was going to ask you if you thought you would have taken four tires. Do you think you would have had enough maybe for the win?
I think I was about 0.2 off both Tyler and Dylan tonight, so it would have been a tall order. But nonetheless, a great finish for the number 14 PowerTek Power Solutions Chevy. Couldn't be prouder. I mean, a great clean race. These guys all came out. They brought their A game, and kind of nice to start turning the season around right here.
Certainly is, and maybe we can stick it in victory lane next week. James, who do you want to thank tonight for the third place finish?
I got to give a thanks to my spotter, Mitch Lennon. Kind of seeing me through the traffic, through the wrecks, did a great job for me tonight. Thank our admins here for throwing in little tidbits here and there. And I want to give a good shout out to a couple of guys I ran tight all night. Sean Medling, Scott Wallace, Brent Sturgeon, Dylan Brockwell, William Roberts. I mean, lots of good side-by-side racing. Everybody was giving everybody a lot of respect and made it an enjoyable deal tonight. And happy to take away third.
Sounds great. Well, the excited James Ross comes out third tonight. Sounds like he had a good time on the track, just like we did up in the booth tonight. I'm going to send it down with Matt Weisbrook, the lovely Matt Weisbrook, who's caught up with second place Dylan Brockwell, the lovely Dylan Brockwell. Matt?
Thanks a lot, Ben. I'm down here with Dylan Brockwell, the driver of the number 20 Sam Bass Galleries Chevrolet. Dylan, congratulations on your second place finish tonight. What got you here?
A big one is Dave Washington. As my spotter, helped me through all the wrecks and helped me keep my cool under getting caught up in a couple of things tonight. Even though we came home second, this is definitely a win for us. After last week, this is a good rebound, and we're looking forward from here.
Dylan, you were battling with the number one car there on the restarts. How was Tyler just getting away? I mean, you guys were doing really well. Kind of take us through your race on the restarts there.
We just needed long runs. That's all it was. They'd get away from me the first couple of laps, and we'd start coming back to them, but every time we started, it would be a caution. And then that last restart just didn't help at all.
Well, Dylan, you did finish ahead of the points leader tonight, so you'll definitely gain some ground there. Anybody you'd like to thank for your performance tonight and so far for the season?
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to thank Tyler, James, Rick was up there. All them guys were racing with tonight. Started off kind of hectic, kind of scary. They all seemed to settle down, and ended up with a good race. Of course, all y'all in the broadcast booth, these things being live, it's pretty darn cool to be able to go back and check it out and show other people what we're doing on here. It's really neat. And lastly, Sam Bass Gallery and Dave Washington, and also my teammate Mike, had some tough luck today, but we'll get him up there. He'll be all right.
That's right, Dylan. There's always next week, and you got to have give a big shout-out to Dave Washington. He's one heck of a guy and, a champion here at Noble Motorsports. So, once again, Dylan, thanks a lot. Congratulations on your second-place finish. And I believe we have none other than Ian Adams down in victory lane with our winner, the number one car, Tyler McEwen. Yes, that's right. I got it right. Tyler McEwen this time.
Yes, Matt, I am down here in victory lane with the number one car, Tyler McEwen. Tyler, impressive race tonight. You were able to pull it off over Brockwell. Got him a few times on the restart there near the end. What got you out front there?
Restarts. I just got pretty good restarts off of Dylan there. And allowed me to get that lead and kind of stay away from him a bit. He was catching me at one point, and I kind of stayed with him, but luckily I didn't fall that far behind.
Yeah, we were watching those, and when that final caution came out, we expected you to win it starting from the pole there. You were definitely had the restarts down over Brockwell. Like we said, it was an impressive race, and the only other time we've really seen you and Brockwell get racy was at Charlotte. and that came down to fuel strategy, I think it would have been the same tonight. We would have had the same outcome?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, fuel wasn't an issue this race as much as it was at Charlotte. Tires were a big difference at this race. So I had a bit of trouble at the start. The car got a bit loose on me, so it helped me rotate a bit better up until a certain point, but then other than that, I was starting to lose it.
And definitely. And Tyler, anybody you'd like to thank for the win tonight and just how your season's been going so far?
Yeah, I'd like to thank my sponsor, Molson Canadian, and the Noble Motorsport guys. They put together an awesome event, and I enjoy it every time. And I'm just thankful that I've been finishing so well lately.
Yeah, Tyler, thank you for interviewing, or for coming up here for the interview. Thank you. We're going to send it off to Matt. He's gonna bring our results in here.
All right, Ian, glad to be back up here in the booth. Wild night here at Dover, so a few cautions, not as many as last week as we had at Iowa, but a good race overall. We're going to run you through the final results here as we wait for our lovely Ian Adams to get back up here in the booth. Coming home in first position, you heard it here first on Noble Network One, the number one car of Tyler McEwen. Second place, the 20 car of Dylan Brockwell. Third place, the 14 car of James Ross. The fourth place finisher, the 77 of Brent Sturgeon, who was on the pole tonight. The fifth place finisher, 51 car of William Roberts. Sixth, 29 car Ben Nile, who is your series points leader. Seventh, the 5 car of Dylan Lee. Eighth, 73 of Sean Medling. Ninth, the 75 of Ronald Henry. And 10th place, the 66 of Scott Wallace.
And Matt, good to be back up here in the booth. I just stumbled in, but we'll run you through 11th here. William Long in that 16 car able to bring it home 11th. Mike Whitehead in the 99, 12th. Mike Arn comes home 13th. Donathan, after a strong run early, falls to 14th. Seems to be what he's been doing this season. Hopefully he can turn it around. Brian Terry, in-race reporter, was off track 5 laps down. Or he made it. He I think he pulled it behind the wall. Matisse as well. TJ Woodward finished 17th. Stefan Brunel, 18th. Ross Cato, 19th. Kamara comes home 20th. Conway comes home 21st. And Timothy Clausen round up the field after an early incident. He'll bring it home 22nd.
Definitely an interesting race here, Ian. Like I said, we saw several cautions. Saw Tyler McEwen finally able to get that victory that he should have gotten the very first week. But he got it done here tonight. That's all that matters. 3 different winners in 3 different weeks. That's a good thing to see, don't you think?
Definitely, it's going to be a competitive series. We'll have to see here after those 3 have gotten the win, if we can't branch it out even more and get a couple more guys in victory lane, really shake up the points coming to the end of this, or winding it down. But for right now, only 3 races in. We'll get a few more in here, see what we got for the series lineup. Ben, I know you're still down there on pit road. What are your thoughts for tonight's race?
Great race tonight, like I told the CEO, Andy Kunstler. One of the best so far this season. Great racing all around the track, all throughout the field. It's kind of a shame I'm going to have to leave the pit road here within the next few weeks to jump on over to the court side of things. But it has been fun these past 2 weeks, and I am glad you guys have had me.
It's Ben, and we're glad you're down there. Kyle, I know you're still over there in the production booth. Your final thoughts for the night?
Yeah, pretty good race. Fancy pick, Tyler McEwen. Brought home first. We had 8 cautions for 32 laps, 10 lead changers. Been a pretty good season so far. Hopefully it continues on.
Definitely, and like we've been saying, it's been an interesting race. It was definitely something definitely good to see it caution free. Matt, what do we got?
But like all four of us have said, it's an interesting race to watch. Next week we'll leave the tracks such as Charlotte, Iowa, and Dover, and we'll head to New Hampshire for the PowerTek 300. It'll be an interesting race with such a short track. It's some people just can't stay in that place. So we'll find out what happens next week. We'll see if we have the same points leader at the end of the night as we do this week.
Certainly, Matt, it will be an interesting race next week at New Hampshire. Same track, or same size track, a lot different configuration. We will have to see what we get. But for tonight, for everyone up here in the booth, myself, Matt Weisbrot, down on pit lane, Ben Kilcrease in the production booth, Carl Brown, all our sponsors, WileyX, PowerTek Power Solutions, the PowerTek Power Solutions Nationwide Series, Noble Motorsport, Motorsport.com, excuse me. NASCAR Hall of Fame, all those guys. As always, I am Ian Adams, and for everyone else here at Noble Network One, good night.